This is the charging port.
The Lightning is completely battery powered.
It's pretty much the same except for the electric part of it.
There's an accelerator here and the brake is right here, just like in a traditional car.
You can store a huge amount of stuff, wrenches, tools.
And it's showing you there's charging stations right down the block.
Front view, you have the back view.
It feels just like a conventional vehicle.
Today we're going to talk about the top five questions we get about electric vehicles. Question one, what kind of effect does cold weather have on EV range? The heat is typically waste heat coming from the engine, but with an EV, we don't have that waste heat, so it actually needs to create the heat. If you're used to getting about 300 miles on a charge on a full battery, you'd probably be looking in the range of about 225 miles.
One thing I really like is I don't have to go in the dead of winter and go find a gas station and stand outside, and I just plug in the comfort of my garage anytime I want to charge.
One of the things that's actually kind of cool about an EV in the winter is you can warm it up in your garage. About 5 minutes before you leave, just grab your phone and just hit climate and you just warm your cabin. What are the main differences between driving an EV and driving a conventional vehicle? If you can drive a conventional vehicle, you can definitely drive an EV. The main difference is just how you fuel them. They feel like a regular car.
It's pretty much the same. The amount of torque that's available is incredible. It's instantaneous, which is so much fun.
Right now you can be sitting right next to an EV and not even know it. They just plug into a regular outlet. But if you do want to charge your car faster, if you drive a lot during the day, and you like the convenience, you can get a level 2 charger, which is a faster charger installed in your house. It's basically like going from a toaster outlet up to a dryer outlet, and any electrician can do that for you. And if you don't have a favorite electrician, you can call MG&E. We have our Charge at Home program, which can help you install a level 2 charger in your home. Question 3, how will I know where to charge?
I charge virtually 100% in my garage. Plugging it in is super simple. Snap it into the port. I don't have to get out of the vehicle. It's cold, blowy, windy.
So most EVs these days get about 300 miles of range on a single charge, which can get you to Milwaukee and back, or it can get you to the Dells and back. If you're going a little bit further, like to Minneapolis or Chicago, you can use the car's navigation system to point you to where the chargers are.
It'll go through its navigation system and it'll tell you where it is on the map and it'll lead you there.
And in Wisconsin, aside from the chargers we have today, a lot more are being built out. In fact, in the next few years, there's going to be a charger every 50 miles along our major highways. Question 4. How much does an EV cost compared to a traditional vehicle? When you purchase an electric vehicle, whether it's new or used, you can get incentives off the price, the sticker price of the car.
And I don't have to think about all of the maintenance tasks that I had to think about with my gas-powered vehicle.
Because it has fewer moving parts, it has less maintenance. You don't have to get oil changes or transmission fluids or anything like that. So we find that our customers who are charging their EVs at home have substantially lower fuel costs than similar vehicles that are gas powered. And some of our customers are actually spending half of what they would if they had a similar gas vehicle. Electricity is a much more stable fuel, so a lot more predictable in terms of price. So question 5, will an EV last as long as a gas vehicle? There are a lot fewer moving parts, and so there's a lot fewer things to sort of wear down and break over time. And your battery might, you know, slowly lose a little bit of charge over time, but it'll be mostly like almost imperceptible. It's very little. With an EV battery, the car will warm the battery up when it needs to. It'll cool the battery down when it needs to. That's really all intended to extend that battery life as long as possible. So if you're considering an EV and you have more questions like these, we have a lot of resources on our website and you can feel free to reach out. We're here to help.